What is up, everybody? This is your bro J.O. coming to you guys yet with a new video. And for today's video, another episode of J.O. Talk. Today is August 9th, Friday. We're going to be talking about, you know, what's been hot, I guess, as of lately, or, you know, just topics in fashion and shoes. So if you guys like this, please give this a like because it helps the algorithm on YouTube. And let's get right into the video. First off, starting today, I just woke up, you know, got ready, did my thing. As always, I usually do check Hype Never Dies. So a huge shout out to them again. I use them a lot. I usually check what's coming out, or, you know, what's kind of trending and, you know, the fashion side. And I guess today Fendi dropped their clothing collection. So I was looking at it. I mean, they're kind of very unique pieces, as always, you know, designer is always very unique. Just the thing with me now, I feel like Fendi is like the new Gucci. A year, 2 years ago, everybody was wearing like the Gucci Aces, the Gucci hood, the Gucci hoodies, you know, just like straight up Gucci, the Gucci sweats. I remember like everybody was wearing that stuff. I mean, from everybody from YouTube to, you know, people on Instagram. And I feel like, you know, how Gucci is dying down now, I feel like Fendi is gonna really like take over. I think one of the people that kind of helped that movement was for sure like Mayweather. Homie just like Fendi up, down, like everything, like Fendi dripped out. So I feel like, yeah, this is the new wave going into like 2020, you know, the end of 2019. I feel like we're gonna see more of Fendi. Fendi's gonna just get even more hotter than what it is now. So I mean, if you do like the pieces, I always do recommend, you know, taking your time and truly considering, especially if you're, you know, on a budget, take your time when purchasing designer. But besides that, if you do like something, I mean, cop it, because it's just going to get hot from here on now. I think the next topic for sure we're going to talk about has to be Kith and Coca-Cola collab. I really like when, like, companies just collab with clothing in a way. Like, it has not, like, Coca-Cola has nothing to do with like fashion, I guess you can say, but lately it has, like with the collabs with Kith and Ronnie Fieg. I think they're really like dope, and this collection drops today at 11 a.m. so by the time this video's up, it's already gonna be dropping. But I mean, I kind of do like the pieces. I just, obviously, I can't really rock with, like, if you know me, my style, I don't really rock with brands like that. But I really do appreciate, like, you don't always have to buy everything, but you can always appreciate art, you know, or like you can appreciate other people's style, fashion, and that's just how I am in general. But oh damn, my burp. But yeah, like, for sure, it's a clean collab. I really like what he's doing, Ronnie Fieg in general, with Kith brand, Kith store. I would really like to go there, so for sure one of my bucket lists is to end up going to one of those stores and probably go to Kith Treats if possible. And yeah, I mean, just a, you know, low-key collab. If you guys like that, bright logos, definitely check it out. The last streetwear company I think I'm going to be talking about today for sure is going to be Antisocial Social Club. I mean, most people already have an idea of what they think about this brand in general. Some people like it, some people hate it. As of lately, I feel like, I haven't really rocked with it. I never really bought anything from it. I never really liked it that much. It's simple, like, yeah, I mean, I do like the simplicity, but I don't know, like, I'm a very social person, so I can't really, you know, relate, as weird as that sounds. But I guess this is a China exclusive drop, so they're gonna just be dropping exclusively in China. So I mean, I think it still has its fans, even though most people don't really like it, or I feel most people here in the States don't really rock with Antisocial Social Club like that. They have their own fans, you know, like most brands. I think they cater to their fans, and I think that's smart, you know, for brands to cater to not the masses, but cater to those who really mess with what they're doing and really respect where they're taking the brand and stuff. So yeah, this is a China exclusive. I just wanted to give my opinion on it, just because, you know, I like to give my opinion on things like this, and I can just talk about this for days. And yeah, I mean, it looks very clean, very simple. I mean, if you rock with the brand, like I said, I feel like people in China do rock with it. Obviously, it wouldn't be dropping over there if it wasn't. I'm sure it'll do fine, but yeah, I mean, let me know what you guys think about Antisocial Social Club in the comments down below. I would like to read those. And then after that, going on to, you know me, I like to plug you guys on brands you haven't heard about, or, you know, always expose other, not expose, but expose you guys, like, get you that exposure to other brands, you know, push your boundaries a bit. I know I like to do that, like, little by little, and not really, like, full in. But the brand that I'm going to be talking about that I ran into like this week for sure had to be humanerror.la. Their Instagram, it's very like grunge, so I mean, I know I wouldn't rock with everything for sure, but I really like how like the mask, like I always thought face mask in general was cool, but this one with like spikes, it's just like, it's scary, you know. So like, if you, if you want to give out like a scary vibe, you know, I don't know what most people who dress grunge like try to, what vibes they try to get, but for sure I think this is hard. Like me, when I used to run a lot, I used to wear a training mask, so it kind of gives me that vibe with the training mask in general. But besides that, they also got some other cool pieces in there. I really like when they do like, I would say like this detailing, like in general, like detailing around the hood or just like other metals around like the clothing and stuff. Like I really like that. Like that's just, it goes to show that they just went more than just your like average hoodie or like average sweater. Like they thought more about it and they wanted to give a different type of feel to it, and I really like that. And like I really respect that. I honestly don't know who's the creative director of this, but I really do rock with it. And then I think that's all for clothing. Today we're going to be talking also about sneakers. I feel like I didn't really cover a lot of sneakers on the other video, so I want to for sure talk about more sneakers in this video. I think right now the most of the leaks that I have seen are for sure Nike, and I honestly think they have been taking over this year and maybe coming into the next year. I feel like Puma's trying to get in there, but it's not even close. And Adidas, we all know, had like its years, you know, it had its time with the Ultra Boost and the NMDs. And for sure, I think Nike's like, they're trying to take the throne. And an example of how they're doing that is like with the collabs they've been doing, like the Travis Scott, we all know that. And, you know, the Off-Whites, like they've been really trying to push those. But actually this month, we see another Off-White. I want to call this like Heineken, but just because it reminds me of like that beer, the Heineken beer. It's just a Nike Dunk. I don't know if it's a SB Dunk, but it's just a Nike Dunk. Green, and then that orange lace that goes like really, like, it's not your typical lace. It just goes around the shoe in general. You guys are going to see in the pictures. It's very unique. But me, I wouldn't rock that, to be honest. Like, for sure, for the hype, if you guys are into that, obviously most people are. I mean, not most people are, but I feel like a couple people who are sneakerheads like the hypey stuff. It is very unique, you know. It's Off-White, it's gonna break next. But I mean, me, I personally wouldn't cop. But I mean, obviously it's gonna have resale value. So if you guys are into that, I don't know whoever is into that, it will for sure have resale value. I don't know when it does come out. It's just a sample according to this post, but I mean, overall, solid shoe. Nike, it's gonna sell out. I really base my opinions on the numbers of sales and stuff. Like, I really try to get in that mindset of like how well is it gonna do, you know, like in the market, or just if it's gonna sell out or not. This shoe right here, Nike also is working on the Air Jordan 3 Knicks colorway. It's gonna be releasing according to here September 21st, but you know, like most things, these dates aren't like 100% accurate, so they might change, so always keep that in mind. I mean, it's just a Jordan 3. I don't really rock with Jordans. I know most people who know me know that I don't really rock with Jordans just because I feel like I can't pull them off. I do like the ones though, but I like the ones, I don't love the ones, like I say. But besides that, I mean, I don't think this colorway is going to do that good. I mean, not everybody's a Knicks fan, you know what I'm saying? And I mean, it's a solid colorway, but I feel like it'll sit for a bit. But if you guys are interested, September 21st, I believe. Yeah. And then after that, I saw the Supreme Dunks, I believe. The SB Dunks. These are SB Dunks. These colors I really like, but just how I feel like when you do a collab with Nike and Supreme, it has to be like kind of unique. And I mean, yeah, they did throw in the embroidery and the jewel swoosh, but I feel like a lot of people were pretty let down. I honestly haven't seen them on foot because I think most people's opinion change when you see them on foot and how you can rock them. But me, for sure, the red colorway, I know I'm not gonna get, like, I wouldn't rock that type of red. But this black and gray, like, maybe, but it's just not, like, I like it how I say it. I don't love it. And yeah, I mean, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna sell out. It'll do fine. I mean, just stay tuned for sure on the Supreme website when they drop their fall winter season. But yeah, I honestly don't see myself ever buying something like this in the long run or in general. But if you guys are interested, good resale value. But besides that, I think that's pretty much it. And then lastly, I'm gonna talk about these. I really like this colorway of the Jordan 1s. They're called Obsidian Jordan 1s, and these are going to be releasing August 31st. My opinion on them, I think the colorway, the blocking is very subtle, very fresh, very clean. I think they should have dropped this for sure, I think, earlier in the month, just because I feel like fall is already creeping up and coming up. This is kind of a summer, spring shoe, I feel. This one really would have gone well with like the hot pink that came out not that long ago. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be like that. Pretty massive numbers, I feel like Nike has been like over pumping the market with this Jordan, but it does very well. So you have to understand, besides it like going out into the market, you know, and releasing a ton of it, it does really well. Like it speaks for itself how well it does, and Nike is going to continue that until they see that the numbers aren't there. So as long as people want it, it's going to just keep going up. So definitely, you know, keep that in mind if you really want them. I'm sure they'll have enough. So if you're interested, I mean, don't always sleep. I feel like, you know, the early, what is it? How's that saying go? The early bird gets the worm. I feel like you just always have to be like that with shoes in general. So definitely, you know, keep your eyes out. Am I gonna cop? No, I mean, I'm not really gonna. It's rare for me to cop something I truly want. Maybe I feel like, you know, coming into like the fall, I already know what shoes I want, so I feel like I'll make a video on that when I do cop. But I'll for sure cop because it's just like a regular shoe. My bad, y'all. My battery died, so I had to swap that real quick. Actually no, my card got full and I had to swap that real quick. I said that was going to be the last shoe, but I just remembered going through the website or going through the page that I'm using VStella now. This is another page that I use to keep an eye on the leaks. But I remembered two other shoes came into mind. I was talking about the Carolina Off-White Dunks. I feel like that's what they're going to be called. I'm not sure what they're going to be called, but, you know, has that Carolina color. Same thing as the Heineken ones. It has that weird string or the shoelace that goes around it. Basically, I don't know what purpose it serves, but it's around the regular shoelaces. Pretty solid colorway. I'm pretty sure it's going to do fine. I really do like the color. I don't really wear a lot of baby blue, though, so I feel like, nah, for sure. Again, I wouldn't cop. I feel like people are just gonna be saying, like, damn, this guy really a sneakerhead because he's not really copying anything. It's just not that. Like, I really like longevity in my shoes. Like, I feel like I need to rock them. So, like, now, you know, all the shoes that I wear aren't really bright. They're kind of simple, and that's what I like in my collection. You know, everyone's got their own cup of tea, I guess you can say. And, yeah, that's what I like. this one right here, this shoe already came out right here, the one I'm about to show. And this shoe is one that I truly like. I'll for sure probably cop it in the month, in 2 months or so, if it's still up, to be honest. I don't really go into my purchases right away. I really like to put some thought into them, because that truly, you know, goes to show how much I value my purchases. And this right here are some denim Converse. I think denim in general is like the best material, the best fabric anybody can have. It lasts you forever. And that's why I really like these Converse. Most of my collection, I already have 3 pairs of Converse, so adding a 4th pair would make sense. This denim, the wash, it seems pretty dope. So I can see myself honestly finally copying something that I truly like. These should have came out already, but I was on the Converse website and I couldn't seem to find it. So I'll probably definitely check again to see if it came out. But it's a Chuck 70, not your regular, you know, budget friendly Converse. This one's a little more expensive than the usual, but I think having that premium on the Converse in general does make it a whole lot better. And it usually has a thicker sole, and you know, just has that thicker sole that definitely doesn't like wear out as quick, and it just cleans off easier. So definitely, if you guys do like Converse, check these out. I feel like this is probably one of the best shoes you can get for like less than $100, I believe. Yeah, besides that, that's all we're going to be talking about today. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this video. Please like this video if possible, just because it does help the algorithm and does help my video be exposed out into the world that is content, and we all know. And again, if you feel like following me on Instagram, it's going to be down below in the description as well as at the end of this video. So thanks again. Llaman pa' que yo la pruebe, y cuando yo la toco, eso llueve ahí. Ella se vestió, la desvestí.